You can include multiple grids on a single SmartView worksheet. The selected grids can be from the same data source or different data sources. You can retrieve data in these grids and work with each grid independently from one another. Let's start by opening an ad hoc grid. To open a second ad hoc grid, I'll select a range of cells, at least two rows, and two columns. I can include an ad hoc grid from a form or from a queue, and I can use the same queue or different cubes. I don't see an option for using multiple grids. It looks like I need to set that up. I'll navigate to Settings to choose the multiple grid option. There are two settings, Native, which is the default setting and does not allow multiple grids on a single SmartView worksheet, and Standard, which does allow multiple grids. I'll change this to Standard. I'll start with a new worksheet and add one grid, and then a second grid. This time a prompt gives me the option to work with multiple grids, and I'll add another grid. You only need to select the multiple grid option the first time you add more than one grid. Let's set up the first grid. I'll select an account. With multiple grids on a single SmartView worksheet, you modify the point of view, POV, for each grid individually using the specific in-grid POV. Let's include some additional periods. I'll zoom out on Q2, and I'll zoom in on your total so that I can see all the quarters. Notice as I drill down on members and select members in one grid, the other grids adjust to fit within the provided space. I'll keep one entity, and I'll zoom in on an account. I'll use ad hoc commands, such as remove only, and I'll zoom in on the time periods so I can see the months in the first quarter. You can enter and submit data on grids. I'll enter data for rent expense in one grid and utilities in another one. To save your data, use Submit It. There are three options for submitting data. Submit Data submits the data on the selected grid. With multiple grids on a worksheet, you save data on one grid at a time. I'll enter data for both office supplies and postage. I'll select the postage data and submit it using the Submit Data Range option. Submit Data Range only submits data for the selected group of cells on the grid. The office supplies data was not saved. Before we take a look at another submit option, I'll remove data for an account. I'll change some data in the top grid. Notice that data for office supplies was not modified. I'll submit without refresh. Next, I'll refresh to see the data that is stored in the cube. There is data for telephone expenses, an account I changed, and for office supplies, an account I did not change. Submit data without refresh submits all data on the selected grid, whether or not you modified the data. I'll create a freeform grid by entering members onto the worksheet. I'll associate my freeform grid to a cube. I'll open a second grid a little further down on the worksheet, and I'll respond to the multiple grid prompt. You can add columns and rows to your ad hoc grids. I'll add a column so that the second quarter is displayed. After filling out the column's information, I'll refresh to see the data. I'll also add a row and fill in the labels for that new row. I'll refresh to see the data. You can perform other ad hoc actions. For example, you can include functions, insert comments, and run business rules in ad hoc grids. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.